So it occurred to me last night that there was a huge contradiction in a lot of the stateless libertarian positions, and that drove me to make a blog post. Link in the description, but I really want to go into detail here about what I was saying. Now, I never understood why it was so bad to be involved in voting as an ANCAP. I've heard people try to make a case against it, but it never really resonated with me at all. Why was it so easy to? Why was it so evil to vote? Why were so many of the arguments against voting so bad? And it dawned on me while listening to someone explain the virtues of trying to get on a jury, all of the reasons contradicted their stance on voting. And here I'll try to explain what the positions are, are against voting and how they can be used to impeach the arguments for people encouraging jury nullification. All right, so one, it is a waste of time. Voting is a relatively small use of time, at most a couple times a year if you include local elections, once every 2 years for bigger elections, and twice in a four-year period for presidential-related elections, primaries and generals. Usually the process takes less than an hour each, and if you include the travel to the polling places, even during peak times. Now, jury nullification takes days, weeks, months, and sometimes years from jury selection to trial to verdict. And that's only for one trial. And depending on your state, you can be summoned once every couple of years. Even if you vote in every single election, you would not spend nearly the same amount of time, even if you were selected out at the beginning of a jury selection. So I don't understand that contradiction. Number two, you're sanctioning state violence. If you accept this, then you must accept that it's even more so true for jury duty. Not only are you willingly participating, you're also taking funds to do so when you can opt out for more pay at your place of employment. I mean, $5 a day in most places, civil cases that last more than a year, you probably get, what, $50 a day? I mean, even minimum wage pays more than that. Any libertarian can legally and legitimately avoid jury duty by honestly informing the judge that you think the state and this court is illegitimate. So why not just do that? It's not like they're going to throw you in a cage for that. Let's see. The chances of your vote mattering are too small or totally ineffective. This is mostly based off of assuming that people vote in general elections and mostly for the president. Votes can go a very long way in local elections and usually prevent the more evil people from getting their leg in the door. And even when people vote in these smaller elections, they usually vote for one or two of the candidates and they skip the judge section and the ballot initiatives they don't understand. And if you understand them and they can make a positive change or a negative change if they get passed, then voting for it is actually not that much of a bad thing. They often run in a lot of off years that most people who vote don't vote in. So again, local judges, ballot initiatives are good places to kick out the shitcocks. Number four, it's an ineffective way of spreading libertarian ideas. As opposed to personally trying to talk to 12 old people who make up a jury to go the libertarian route and nullify a law, which they may see as sometimes good. Even if you could convince them that Joe Blow wasn't a bad guy for heroin possession, they would still think all the other druggies were deserving of a cage. Now, how many libertarians do you know who were influenced by Harry Brown's campaign or Michael Badnarik's campaign or Ron Paul? If your goal is to turn more people on to libertarianism, it seems like voting has to be the clear winner here between the two. I was first turned on to libertarianism when I heard about a jury nullifying a drug possession law, said no one ever. And then five, so how is it working out for you? Actually, it's doing fairly great. Even the last 20 years, there have been some significant gains and even some significant setbacks, which need to be mentioned. But marijuana legalization, the laxing of gun control laws are two of the biggest. A lot of which had its genesis in voting. It could have been a lot more, but, we don't vote. But the real question is, how has jury nullification been doing over the last 20 years? How many laws were revoked? Yeah, I didn't think so. So the point of that thing that I wrote on Facebook, and then later I kind of edited up a little bit and posted on my blog, was to show that these are contradictory ideas. Jury duty seems to be a far less effective version of voting, but people are perfectly okay with that for the same reasons they oppose voting. And Now, you can go either way with this, and it'd be fine, because as long as you're being consistent, that's great. Either you need to oppose jury nullification or be trying to get involved in jury notification and voting, or, you know, spend an hour to, you know, vote out the shitcocks before they get famous. So I want to know what your thoughts are. Maybe I'm thinking this thing wrong, but I want to hear your guys' opinions. Worms.